In today's tutorial, we are going to turn this 3D view into this 3D view. There is a few different ways we can do this. In this tutorial, I'm just going to do the basics, which is doing 3D view on the GrandMA OnPC itself. You can network two computers if you need more real estate to program on one computer and see your 3D view on another one, or you can network a real GrandMA3 console to a computer, and that way you can use the second computer as a visualizer. In this tutorial, we are just going to do it on the OnPC version itself. In a later tutorial, I will explain all the networking possibilities you have on the GrandMA3 console. If you feel like something is missing or there's something you need to know, please leave a comment below in the comment section and I will try to explain it as good as I can. So here we are. I started a small sequence now so we can see what we're doing. I added a gobo to the vibers and I just turned on the Mac Auras here in blue and then all my dimmers just pointing up in the air. So right now we're going to play with the quality of the rendering. Right now, the rendering is pretty much standard. That means this is the rendering you're going to see on the console. If you use a console, you can't set the quality as high as we're going to do now because the console is going to use too many resources on it. So if you want the high quality and you're working on a real GrandMA3 console, you have to attach a computer to the console to make sure that you can do your rendering there and the computer can prioritize the rendering and the console can prioritize what it's supposed to do. But let's start up. Let's go up here into the MA button up here and push it. And here we have all the settings for the 3D view itself. We have some beam options. When you turn up and down the beam options, the beams are getting brighter. And if you turn it all the way down, they're just gonna disappear and you can only see the footprint. The same with the spot. You can turn the spot down. This is the footprint on the floor. You can turn it up, you can turn it down, depending on what you want to do. I'm just going to keep these two at about 100%, but if you have some special need, you can just put it up or down so it fits your need. The ambient light is the light in the room in here. You can turn the ambient light down. It gets darker in the room, and if you do the point light as well, it's going to be black. I need a little bit of ambient light in here, otherwise we can't see the surroundings. Now, here we have beam quality. If you push this one, you will have a lot of different options. If you right-click, you can see all the different options you have. So right now, we're just going to set it to the highest options we can. So high, shadow, fancy is the one we selected right now. The spot quality down here, if you right-click again, you can see we use gobo. And the bloom intensity is set to on right now. This is already helping a lot on the quality. If we go into the miscellaneous tab, we can see right now that we can't see any frames per second. This is important if your computer is not so powerful. Then you can see how much you're pushing it. The lower the frame rate goes, my screen is only a 60 hertz screen, so it can't go any higher. But it's around 60 frames per second, which is fine. You can turn on wireframe if you want to make it really simple. This is how it looked on the GrandMA2 on the console itself. But what we need to do, especially if you attach a computer to the console itself, you can set the 3D priority. If you set the 3D priority to the console, if you turn that on, the console is going to use up all its energy on rendering the view here and not on what it's supposed to do, calculating all the DMX values. But since we are on a OnPC right now, we can just turn on the 3D priority like this, and it's going to ask you, are you sure you want to enable 3D priority? And we just say yes. So right now, if we are in a network and we have multiple consoles and multiple MA computers running the same software, we can set one of them or two of them or whatever you want to do to have the 3D priority. So it's going to do the calculation and leave the heavy lifting of the DMX calculation to the console. In here we have some other options. Lens shading, we can turn that on, and we have some separated beams here. And again, if you right click, you can see all the options you have, and we say single beam dynamic gobo. We can move into label. Label I showed you in the last episode, and if you missed that one, by the way, how to set up your 3D view, how to position all your fixtures in the 3D universe, check out episode 4. I'm going to link to the episode right up in the top hand corner. And by the end of the video, I'm going to link to the playlist so you can see all the GrandMA3 tutorial videos. In here, we have some labels. We can put a label on the body if we want to know which fixtures are where. And then we can see, okay, what do we want to see right now? Right now, we see the fixture handle. We can turn on the CID, which doesn't have any right now. We can turn on the patch to see where are they patched, the different spots. And if they have a name, if you named them right, you can see the name as well. And you can turn on all of them, and then you can't see anything. So basically, I just need the fixture ID when I work with it. But in the 3D view, I don't want to see the label. Right here, you have the, we'll just turn it on again, the background alpha. You can turn that down, and that means the label gets transparent. And if you do the other one, the text itself is going to be transparent. Into the quality tab again, you have some different options. If you take this up or down, you take this all the way down, you can see the resolution on the footprint is going to be distorted. If you take it all the way up to 100% again, it's going to be much more sharp, and it's going to use more resources to render that view. The light scale, I don't really see any difference, but if you maybe there's a difference in the footprint. Yeah, there is. There's a small difference in the footprint. You see, it's once again, it's out of focus. It's more distorted. And the same here, how many pixels you're going to use in the shadows. I don't see much of a difference right here. So this is basically how you set up your 3D view and turn up the quality of the view itself. If you find it interesting, please give the video a like. And otherwise, you can check out the next video. It's on the playlist right here in the top, or the next video down in the bottom. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time on my channel. Thank you. Bye-bye.